Good evening to all the persons here. In this session, we are going to see about the voltage divided by a circuit. In the previous session, we have seen about the collector to base by a circuit. That is, in that session, there may be, it may contain some disadvantages. That is, what are all the disadvantages? That is, in the collector to base by a circuit, it can be overcome with the help of the voltage divider circuit. That is, in the collector to base bias circuit, they provide negative feedback which reduces the gain of an amplifier. So, but in the case here, in the voltage divider bias circuit, we can able to overcome that disadvantage of the collector to base bias circuit. That is, the voltage divider bias circuit, which is as shown in the figure, it will be having a capacitor C1 and resistance R1 and R2, and it will be having a collector resistance RC and emitter resistance RB. So this voltage divider bias circuit is otherwise called as the cell bias circuit, or it may be called as the emitter bias circuit. In the explanation of the diagram, it is a most stable biasing circuit. That is, biasing is provided by the three resistance, that is R1, R2 and R. The resistance R1 and R2, it will act as a potential divider, or it may be called as the voltage divider circuit. If collector current increases due to change in temperature or change in beta, the emitter current IE also increases, and the voltage, that is the voltage drop across RE increases. That is, reducing voltage difference between base and emitter. Due to reduction in VBE, base current IB and hence IC also reduces. Hence, a negative feedback exists in the emitter bias circuit. This reduction in IC compensates for original value change in IC. If the temperature increases, ICO also increases. ICO increases, then collector current will be increased. Therefore, the voltage drop across IE also increase, decreasing base current and collector current, and thereby increasing the emitter resistance. In the analysis, we have to follow the voltage divider rule, that is the total voltage into particular resistance divided by sum of all resistance. By applying voltage divider rule, that is VB equal to VCC into RC divided by R1 plus R2. That is, by applying KVL to the base side input circuit, VB minus VBE minus VE equal to 0, and also VE equal to IE into RE, or VE equal to VB minus VBE. And from equation 2, and also we have to equate equation 3 and 4, IE RE equal to VB minus VBE, and IE will be equal to VB minus VBE. It will be shown in the figure. That is, by applying Kirchhoff's voltage law at the input circuit base current, VTH minus IRB IB minus VBE minus RE IE equal to 0. That is, VTH is equal to R2 divided by R1 plus R2 into VCC. This denotes the voltage divider rule. And also VTH is equal to R2 divided by R1 plus R2 into VCC. Or RTH, that is R Thevenin, is equal to R1 parallel R2. Or RTH is equal to R1 R2 divided by R1 plus R2. That is, R2 divided by R1 plus R2 into VCC equal to RB IB VBE plus RE IE. From equation, it may be shown that VTH is equal to RB IB plus VBE plus RE into IC plus IB. That is, VTH is equal to RBIB plus VBE plus IC into RE plus IB into RE. VTH minus VBE equal to RBIB plus beta into IB into RE plus IB into RE. Therefore, IC is, as we already know, the collector current is equal to beta into IB. So VTH is equal to VTH minus VBE equal to IB into RB plus beta RE plus RE. Or IB equal to VTH minus VBE divided by RB plus 1 plus beta into RE. There is a difference in 1 plus beta RE compared to other techniques. And also, if we going with the collector circuit by applying KVL at the output side, from the figure VCC minus ICRC minus VCE minus IERE equal to 0, VCE minus equal to VCC minus ICRC minus IERE, or VCE equal to VCC minus ICRC minus IC into RE, or VCE equal to VCC minus IC into RC plus RE. And we have to find out the value for IC. IC equal to VCC minus VCE divided by RC plus RE. These are all the values that is shown here. And also, if we find out the value for the stability factor, that is R1 and R2 is replaced by RB and RTH and RTH and VTH. RB is parallel combination of R1 and R2, VTH is a Thevenin's voltage. Applying KVL to the input, that is base, therefore we can able to find out the stability factor. S is equal to 1 plus beta divided by 1 minus beta into dou IB divided by dou IC. To find the value for dou IB divided by dou IC, IB equal to VTH divided by RB plus RC minus VBE divided by RB plus RE minus ICRE divided by RB plus RC. Differentiating the above equation with respect to IC, that is dou IB divided by dou IC equal to VTH, this term, the first term will become 0 and second term will also become 0. In the third term, it will be IC, it will be 1, so RE divided by RB plus RC. So dou IB divided by dou IC equal to minus RE divided by RB plus RE. And also, we have to substitute the value of dou IB in the stability factor formula. Therefore, S is equal to 1 plus beta divided by 1 minus beta into minus RE divided by RB plus RE. As we already know, minus to minus plus. So S is equal to 1 plus beta divided by 1 plus beta into RE plus RB plus RE. Or it can be written as 1 plus beta divided by cross multiplying RB plus RE plus beta into RE divided by RB plus RE. Or S is equal to 1 plus beta into RB plus RE divided by RB plus RE plus beta into RE. And you have to divide the each term by RE. 1 plus beta into 1 plus RB divided by RE divided by RB plus RE plus 1 plus beta. So S is equal to 1 plus beta into 1 plus RB divided by RE divided by 1 plus beta plus RB divided by RE. As we already know that is the above equation RB plus RE is less than 1. So it will be eliminated. That is RB plus RE will be get eliminated. So S is equal to 1 plus beta divided by 1 plus beta. So both get cancelled. You will get S is equal to 1. And also for the next term, there is a stability factor. S dash will be equal to dou IC divided by dou VBE. ICO comma beta will be kept constant. That is IC divided by beta will be equal to VTH minus VBE minus ICRE divided by RE RB plus RE. IC divided by beta will be equal to VTH minus VBE divided by RB plus RE minus ICRE divided by RB plus RE. And by taking ICRE divided by RB plus RE to the LHS side, that is IC divided by beta plus IC RE divided by 1 divided by RE plus RB, RE plus RB, that will be equal to VTH minus VBE divided by RB plus RE. And IC into 1 plus beta 1 divided by beta plus RE divided by RB plus RE which is equal to VTH minus VBE divided by RB plus RE. And by taking LCM, the LHS side, IC into RB plus RE plus beta into RE divided by beta into RB plus RE equal to VTH minus VBE divided by RB plus RE. IC equal to VTH minus VBE into beta into RB plus RE divided by RB plus RE into RB plus RE plus beta into RE. So by cancelling RB plus RE in the numerator as well as in the denominator, so IC equal to beta into VTH minus VBE divided by RB plus RE into 1 plus beta. IC equal to beta into VTH divided by RB plus RE into 1 plus beta minus VBE into beta divided by RB plus RE into 1 plus beta. RS dash is equal to dou IC divided by dou VBE. We have to differentiating with respect to VBE. Therefore, dou IC divided by dou VBE equal to 0. First term it will become 0. Second term it will be beta into beta divided by RB plus RE into 1 plus beta. So S dash is equal to minus beta divided by RB plus RE into 1 plus beta. Next, third term stability factor S double dash. S double dash will be equal to dou IC divided by dou beta. By keeping the IC, that is the reverse leakage current ICBO and VBE constant. So IC is equal to beta into VTH minus VBE divided by RB plus RE into 1 plus beta. This also same as of the stability factor of the collector to base bias circuit. By using U by V form, that is U by V is equal to VDU minus UDV divided by V square. Therefore, dou IC divided by dou beta equal to RB plus RE into 1 plus beta into VTH minus VBE minus beta into VTH minus VBE into RE divided by RB plus RE into 1 plus beta the whole square. So therefore it can be written as VTH minus VBE into RB plus RE divided by RB plus RE into 1 plus beta the whole square. So dou IB divided by dou beta will be equal to VTH minus VBE into RB plus RE divided by RB plus RE into 1 plus beta into RB plus RE into 1 plus beta. So therefore IB will be equal to VTH minus VBE divided by RB plus RE